There's something about growing a beard that just makes you want to pick up a power tool and a measuring tape and, you know, upgrade your home Wi-Fi.
Yeah, as it turns out, the beard really doesn't change much. I'm still me.
And me hasn't upgraded the wireless access point in my upstairs hallway for 5 years. I mean, that kind of makes sense. I did spend $1,000 on it with the intention of it being my endgame wireless networking solution. And it does still deliver over 40 megabytes per second to nearby clients. But it also has next to nothing in the way of management features because I didn't buy the controller hardware, and poor reception in both my back and front yard. Time to fix that up in a hurry. Wish me luck. Step number one is to sort through all this gear from Ubiquiti. Some of it is for a future video, upgrading my home security setup. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. And some of it is for the Wi-Fi upgrade today. This right here is the Base Station XG. This is an outdoor rated access point that is freaking nuts. It's got this shape because it's kind of more of a directional style Wi-Fi access point, but I did not expect the size or the weight. It's got weather resistant plugs down here, so that one's gigabit, and this one is 10 gig? What kind of speeds are they expecting you to get on this thing? What are they expecting you to put this thing on? Listen to this. Oh, I know what this is. This is their power splitter doodad thing. So you put one AC input here, and then they've got this special power connector for their like rack mount devices, so you can power everything off of one power port. This we're gonna need today. 24 ports of Ubiquiti power over Ethernet goodness. So we've got a couple of 10 gig SFP plus ports, so we can use that to go back to the main switch, and then the rest of them are regular gigabit power over Ethernet. So that'll handle our Wi-Fi access points and the new security cameras. The Unify Dream Machine Pro, this thing's super cool. It's kind of like an all-in-one unit, but not in a bad way. So it's your router, it's your security gateway. It also has, check this out, a 3.5-inch drive for video recording, so it handles all of your security stuff, and you can use it as your cloud key. So you don't need a dedicated VM or a little dedicated dongle in order to run and manage all of your Ubiquiti hardware. This is what they've made such bold claims about. This is the UAP XG. What they say is the world's most powerful access point, and they've got comparative numbers right up on their website comparing to devices from brands like Ruckus that I know from my experience offer amazing Wi-Fi performance. Now, this is not Wi-Fi 6. Ubiquiti actually has not jumped into the Wi-Fi 6 game yet, but given that we don't actually have any Wi-Fi 6 devices in the house, since I'm back on my Note 9 again, I'm not too worried about that now. I am more interested in just having something that's easy to manage and has absolutely flawless coverage over my entire property. More 10 gig inputs. Dang. One of the big problems I have is operating my smart garage door from the end of my driveway, and oh well, naturally, as soon as I go to demo that it's not working very well, I actually get a pretty solid result in the end of the driveway here. Well, we'll see how the new one does, I guess. The funny thing about this upgrade is that after my first experience running Ubiquiti products at home, I swore I would never use them here again. It was that notorious square access point that they had a number of years ago that I had as many as 3 of installed in my house, and I still couldn't get decent coverage. This thing, with its anywhere from 200 to 300 to even 400 megabit per second performance all across my house, was like a breath of fresh air. Of course, I've always believed that when you're choosing a product, you should choose the, well, the product, not the brand name. So, especially in light of the excellent experiences we've had with Ubiquiti gear at the office, I'm giving them another shot here. They acknowledge that that Square AP was terrible. Oh, 10 gig, like what?
There.
Apparently, Ubiquiti has a mobile app for quick and dirty provisioning of a single AP, but since I'm gonna wanna be setting this up properly in the longer term anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and do the rack installs now.
Big old PoE switch up next. And now the dream machine.
Man, I just realized there's that 10 gig port on the access point, but the only 10 gigs on the PoE switch are actually SFP plus, so I can't even use them. Honestly, gigabit is probably fine with the number of clients we have here. I doubt we'd max it out anyway. I will definitely need a 10 gig link between this one and this one though, but I don't have the cable here for that now, so I will deal with it later. Now it's time to make a couple cables. I need to go from my ISP provided modem over to the WAN port on my router here. And I also need to go from my router to my switch. We're gonna go from the 10 gig switch. This is just temporary because we'll put in a different one later. And then we'll go from the router over to the main switch. Eventually I'm gonna want a 10 gig connection between my PoE switch here and my 10 gig switch. And I'll just run that from like here to here or something like that. But what I won't probably move to 10 gig is either the WAN port, although technically I think this thing does have an SFP plus port, no point though. So I'm not gonna bother with WAN and I'm not gonna bother going 10 gig from here to here. So I just need to make myself a cable that goes from there to, oh, I don't know, let's say there. Before anyone brings it up, I am aware that generally you'd prefer stranded compared to a solid core cable for an application like this, but this was all we had lying around in Cat 6A, and it's just for me, so I know not to bend it around a bunch, because that's the disadvantage of solid core, is you can fatigue the metal and it can crack and break inside the cable.
Good luck, everybody.
Well, isn't that wonderful? Went to put the kids to bed and boom, internet connected. Dream Machine is connected. Sweet. This is a really slick startup wizard.
LTDstore.com.
Man, they have a nice interface these days. 99% experience. This is a sweet feature, being able to do a quick scan of the RF environment. Obviously, there's other ways to do it. There's phone apps. I had my old Channelizer, Wi-Spy doodad way back in the day, so I could even see things that weren't Wi-Fi devices, but having it just right in here, this easy to use, is pretty great. This is great information. Channel 1 is pretty much wide open, so that'll be a perfect spot to plunk my 2.4 gigahertz SSID on. I only really use it for like random old devices that don't support 5 gigahertz, especially now that I'm making this upgrade and I should have awesome wireless coverage. This is a visualization of data transmissions that are going on across these frequencies. Hallway, check that out. All my stuff's up in here. I remember how to do it now. Once you've created your wireless networks, you just have to go into each radio. So here we've got our 2.4 gigahertz and then our 2.5 gigahertz radios. And then we have to disable. There we go. There we go. And there we go. Now it's time for a quick speed test. Let's just see how we're doing here. Bear in mind, of course, I'm just down the hall from it though. Real nice. You can't tell because it's dark, but we're back at the tree now. All right, so that's better than one of my results, but quite a lot lower than one of the other ones. This corner of the house is a lot stronger than before. Looks like the living room is as good or better as well, at least on the download. Well, I'm thrilled. Coverage is as good as what I had before. The interface is fantastic. This has actually gotten like so good since the last time I've looked at it in detail. And while I did have slower uplink speeds in some places, it was not cripplingly slow by any stretch of the imagination, and it's more than made up for by the fact that when I am close to the access point, speeds are, both up and down, way in excess of what I was getting with my old one. We're talking just about 60 megabytes per second sustained on a modern client. That's freaking awesome. Of course, one of my goals was to have Wi-Fi way out in the street in front of my house so that I can be browsing that internet without using mobile data while my kids are playing. So for that, we're gonna have to bring out the big kahuna and crawl around in my attic. I want more wireless range, basically straight out in front of this peak. Oh, right there. Yeah. It's got a pickup pattern that's kind of like that. So I'm thinking I should basically be able to have Wi-Fi anywhere in front of my house. Oh, hello. It's like a dance party in my attic now. If you could just hang out here for, oh no. Oh, yeah, I'm fine. I just almost put a foot through the living room ceiling. Not a lot of extra slack on it, but as long as I nail the termination on the first try, it should be fine. We got lights. That's a good sign.
Connect.
Does this thing not have 2.4 gigahertz support? Oh, weird. It has 3 5 gigahertz radios. It claims Note 9 is on hallway, but that can't be right. I'm gonna unplug it, I don't trust it. All right, now the clients are switching over for sure. All right, let's have a look. The reception sucks though. Only got a couple of bars and speed, not too great. This is good. Everything is behaving as it should. We are behind its pickup pattern. Now let's go out in front of it. Now we've got good reception. That's where it's mounted, up there on that peak. Okay, that is definitely better. Maybe not as better as I might have hoped. Let's go farther away though. I'm now out in the middle of my cul-de-sac, about a stone's throw from my house, and that's looking pretty good. Okay, let's see how far we can take this party. I am now standing on the boundary of my neighbor's yard across the entire cul-de-sac. Dang, still getting 100 megabit, yo. Let's start walking down the street. I'm now about another half cul-de-sac away, down to 2 bars now, but still getting 50 megabit, only 10 up. How am I gonna upload my YouTube stories? Let's go about another cul-de-sac away. Oh, man, I'm like real far away from my house right now. I'm at least 50 meters from my front door. That's 150 feet for my Yankee friends. I am close to 100 meters from my front door now, and I still have 50 megabit on Wi-Fi. Okay, we good. Why does it say Telus Mobility down there? What's it doing? Data not on, ladies and gentlemen. Let's keep walking. You're over 100 meters from my front door now. Got like an epic Wi-Fi emergency here. Get that fire department up in here. Hey, and it's dead. Mission accomplished. We got him. You know what else we got? My segue to our sponsor, Squarespace. When you want to build a website, or even if you don't want to build a website because you don't know you need one yet, Squarespace is the place to go. Squarespace has award-winning templates that'll help make your website stand out instead of looking like it's from the 90s. If you're interested in how your website's doing, they've got built-in tools to help you find exactly what you're doing right and doing wrong, and you can even sell things through Squarespace with tools for managing your inventory. Both our Linus Media Group and LTX Expo websites were built quickly using Squarespace, and if you need help, you can contact their support team 24/7 via live chat and email. So why wait? Go to squarespace.com/LTT and save 10% on your first purchase. We're gonna have that linked down below. If you guys enjoyed this video, maybe you would enjoy the, 6 workstations, no wait, whole house, 1 CPU, where I had a server machine in my closet and ran fiber optic wires all over the house. They're all actually still there, and I do have plans for them for the future, but that video is definitely worth a watch. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. I am so tired, it's time to go to bed.